All right, what's up, everyone? My name is Matt McHugh. I'm one of the high school pastors at HPUMC, and this week we are talking about kings and queens. No.
Long live Queen Elizabeth.
All right, so for some of you that know me, I grew up in Southern California. I love the water, I love the beach. Being out here now in Dallas, I love going to White Rock Lake. I really connect with the water, and on a deeper level, that's how I connect with God. But I want to share a story with you where some of you maybe have traveled to this destination before, but I went to Kauai with my family. Man, I love snorkeling. I love seeing the clear water. I love getting shaved ice with the little ice cream scoop at the bottom, all the different colors. I'd probably get like a kiwi strawberry mix. But there's so much to do out there. So much beauty, the mountains, the waterfalls. And one day, my family and I, we decided, all right, let's go kayaking. And for myself, I'm like, okay, I'm thinking to myself, I could do this. This is going to be super fun. But then I start kind of questioning myself, like, can I do this? Like, kayaking, you need to have a lot of balance. And we were doing the two-person kayaks. We weren't doing the single kayaks at all. So you had to work with someone else. And so I'm out there, and we start paddling, and I'm with one of our family friends, and we keep going. We're paddling. And what ends up happening is that we fall out. And then we get back in. We got our life jackets on, so we're good. And we keep paddling, and we fall out again. And this continued to happen over and over again. So you know what? I was like, all right, I am switching up my partners. This is not working out. And I decided, all right, I'm going to switch out, and I'm going to work with my sister. So we start paddling. We fall out. And then we fell out again and again. Have you ever felt like you're in a situation like this where you feel like you're trying to prevent yourself from falling? Like you were trying to keep your balance maybe? You know, maybe you were trying to put on this happy face where you're smiling and everything's okay, when in reality, you know, things were a lot more confusing and difficult and hard and really frustrating, but you didn't know how to express that. You know, what do you do when things don't go your way? How do you respond? You know, where's God at in all of that? You see, you aren't the first one to ask these questions. There's a guy in the Bible named Daniel. And Daniel is in this new territory. He's in a new culture. He's out having to understand a new language. Everything is new to him. He doesn't know anything, any of the customs. And he walks into this awesome opportunity where he's allowed to basically get a scholarship and learn from the best scholars and be in the king's palace with some of his best friends. So this means like room and board is good. He's got free education. He's going to be learning the culture, reading, learning everything he possibly can, just soaking it all in. But there's this one request that the king makes, and it's kind of an unusual request if we don't understand kind of maybe what's going on in that society at the time. But the king says, hey, I want you to only drink food and wine. So I want you to drink wine, and I want you to eat the specific food, usually probably like something like a meat. And Daniel's a little bit alarmed. He's like, okay, for me and my customs and for me to faithfully serve God, being from the Israelite nation that I'm in, like, I don't know if I can do this. And so he's kind of wrestling, like, do I listen to this king? Do I listen to God? What do I do in this situation, right? What do we do when things don't work out, maybe as we had planned? And so Daniel kind of sits down and he says, you know what? I got an idea. What if for the next 10 days, my buddies and I will decide to drink only water and we're going to eat vegetables and we'll see how that compares to the other people in our class. We'll see who ends up looking healthier, who ends up basically being able to perform at a high level. And then from there, we'll see what happens. And so that's where we pick up. If you have your Bibles, we're in Daniel chapter 1. And this is where the story goes. After the 10 days, this is what it says in verse 15. It says this: at the end of the 10 days, it was observed that they appeared better and fatter than all the young men who had been eating the royal rations. So the guard continued to withdraw the royal rations and the wine they were to drink, and gave them vegetables. To these four young men, God gave knowledge and skill in every aspect of literature and wisdom. Daniel also had insight into all visions and dreams. Y'all see here, like, because Daniel stood with his convictions, because he leaned on his convictions, which ultimately was his faith, look how this played out for him. Like, God was with him every step of the way, and God also gave more knowledge and more wisdom to Daniel because of his convictions. Let's keep reading, verse 18. At the end of the time that the king had set for them to be brought in, the palace master brought them into the presence of Nebuchadnezzar. This is the king at the time ruling in the area, king of Babylon. And the king spoke with them. And among them all, no one was found to compare with Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. Therefore, they were stationed in the king's court in every matter of wisdom and understanding concerning with which the king inquired of them. He found them 10 times better than all magicians and enchanters in his whole kingdom. All right, so I talked a little bit about conviction, right? Out of Daniel's conviction, his faith was being able to be formed because he knew, okay, God, this is an opportunity to basically trust you, God, and give and allow for you, for your wisdom, God, to be brought into this situation. And I think the second point that I want to make here is that this was a testing. This was an opportunity for Daniel to truly believe, okay, God, let me take and receive who you are, and let's see what happens in this situation. So this testing time really gave Daniel perspective. It gave Daniel perspective to see, okay, God, I'm going to trust you in this. I don't know how this is going to turn out. This is definitely not what I had planned, but I will allow this perspective to help me in this process. And so his perspective led to this faithfulness that we see. And ultimately, God's faithfulness leads to a faithful perspective. Because we can see Daniel continuing to trust God, continue to say, okay, God, you're going to be faithful even when I'm in this new area, learning a new language, learning all the new customs, the culture of the day, I can still rely on you even when everything else doesn't make sense. And the last part of that is knowing that Daniel saw himself as an heir. He saw himself when he was listening to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Jesus, God. Like, when he was listening to who God was, his voice, when he was listening to the king's voice, he could be led and compelled into a faithfulness that he wouldn't have been able to have done otherwise. That if he relied on his own strength, or if he just decided to enjoy the food and the wine, he wouldn't have been living into who he was, actually. And so I think this testing ground provided a perspective for him that ultimately led to him continuing to grow in his faithfulness. And so for you, where are you at with this? Is there some areas in your life where you could say, you know what, I feel like I have a faithful perspective of God. I feel like God and I are good in terms of trusting God in every area of my life for God to be faithful. And what areas do you maybe need to grow in your relationship with God? Because there's some promises of God that we just need to learn and to lean into, especially in this season, is one, that God is for us and God is not against us. And two, that we are children of God, and that God looks out after us. God is a shepherd, right? God wants to give us wisdom. He wants us to be able to learn how to decipher and grow in our faith. When there's that testing comes, our hearts are truly revealed. And for Daniel, his heart was revealed that when he chose God, that allowed him to continue to be faithful to God rather than slip away. And so for you, God faithfulness leads to a faithful perspective. I hope this resonates with you as you talk about this in your life groups today. But lean in and just think about, where has God been faithful in my life? And where do I need to grow in maybe my understanding of God to be faithful in other areas? Thank you, guys. We love you so much. We miss you. And we'll see you back next week for Kings and Queens.